Hello everybody. Today on Ask Housing, we're in conversation with Shaishav Dharia, who is the regional CEO at Lodha Group. We're in Mumbai at the company's head office. I'm Jhumur Ghosh, I'm the editor-in-chief of Housing.com News, and we'll be talking to Shaishav today about micro-locations and trends in the Mumbai real estate market that a home buyer simply can't afford to miss. Shaishav, great to have you on our show. I'd like you to get a sense of where do you think the Mumbai market is at currently? I know that the last few quarters have been really tough, not just for the Mumbai market, but all over the country. Where do you think Mumbai stands today? Is the worst over? Do we still have a few tough quarters to go? What's your sense of where the market's at?
So firstly, thank you so much for having me talk to your audience. So I think if you really want to understand the Mumbai market, yes, it's actually important to get a slightly longer perspective.
Yes.
Because the past also gives a better context. Yeah. Real estate, like I was sharing with you, is probably one of the most talked about subjects where everybody has an opinion, right or wrong.
Yes.
Right? So I think you have to step back to probably 2014-15 to understand Mumbai.
Yeah.
I think it was the period where we probably had the highest sales,
yeah,
in the city.
Yeah.
Rough estimates, about 80,000 crores. Right? And we got the peak that time because affordability got very poor.
Yeah.
Prices had gone up very high in the prior 5 years and the homes were very large.
Yeah.
And interest rates were in excess of 10%.
Yeah.
Right? So you already had this slightly overstretched market.
Yes.
And then came the second phase where people started adjusting to it, but then you got these three major shocks.
Yeah.
Right? One is a negative one and two were an adjustment. So you had demonetization in 2016,
yeah,
November.
Yeah.
So for about 3 months, the market pretty much just went quiet.
Yeah.
But what's interesting is that year, 2016-17, I think the sales were about 65,000-70,000 crores. So in spite of 3 months having nothing,
mm,
you still basically had about a 10-15% drop in the market.
Yeah.
Right? And then you had GST and RERA. Those two were important because they are positive events, but it took time for people to adjust.
Absolutely.
And created a period of uncertainty.
Sure.
In spite of that, you'll probably still have this year,
yeah,
being the same as last year, right?
Are you confident about that?
Yeah, I'm confident about that part.
Yeah.
So this is where we've kind of landed up, and that created this perception of the market being sluggish.
Yeah.
And, you know, because yes, overall it did not grow.
Yeah.
Pricing, actually, if you look at it per square foot,
yeah,
remained flat or actually increased each year.
Yeah.
It was only smaller homes.
Yeah.
But there were some really positive things that were happening during that period, which is very important for everyone to understand. So we started getting homes that became more, I would say, practical in size.
Yes.
So you got rid of balconies,
yeah,
useless passages.
Yeah.
Second is interest rates are at about 8.25%,
yeah,
the lowest they've been.
Yeah.
Third is you've got RERA, which is a big booster.
Yeah.
Fourth, if prices have not gone up for very long,
yeah,
income has gone up,
yeah,
interest rates come down,
yeah,
not a whole lot of supply, suddenly affordability has been probably the best it has been in the last 8 to 10 years.
Very true. Yeah.
And then you add one segment in particular, which is the affordable middle class segment.
Yeah. Yeah.
They got a big booster,
yeah,
in terms of the Pradhan Mantri Yojana,
yeah. Yeah.
For people making up to 18 lakh rupees,
yeah,
even lower interest rates.
Yeah.
Developers got benefit with affordable home status.
Yeah.
GST most recently for those homes,
yeah,
came down from 12% to 8%.
Yeah.
So 4% reduction in home buying cost.
Yeah.
So slew of positive events.
Yeah.
And so that takes me to where we are today,
yes,
and the future, right? I think in the affordable middle segment,
yeah,
it's actually not sluggish at all.
Okay.
The last 6 months, 6 to 9 months has seen significant momentum.
Very true. Very true.
And it's only going to get stronger.
Yeah.
You're already seeing even in the, I would say, middle to, you know, higher end segment,
mm-hmm,
you're starting to see the positive movement,
yes,
right? Again, because people are starting to get confidence.
Yeah.
So overall, I see the next 12 to 18 months,
yeah,
very strong in the affordable mid segment,
yeah,
and 6 to maybe 12 months, equally strong in the higher segments.
Yeah. So using this as the starting point, if I were to ask you that, give me top 5 micro locations within the city. Why would they be your top 5? Why would you be rooting for these micro locations?
Sure. So I think the way we look at Mumbai is there are about 8 or 9 micro segments,
yes,
micro markets. And Mumbai is a population of 22 million people.
Yeah.
So there's actually demand everywhere.
Yeah.
But I would put it as the Lodha Group. When we look at which projects are we betting more on, which locations I would try to look for more land, right? That would be my own personal assessment of which micro markets I believe have greater, higher growth potential.
Yeah, because you wouldn't get into the market if it didn't have that.
Exactly, right? So to me, it's two parts. It's all driven by three primary factors. One, infrastructure. What is the city doing in terms of road, rail, connectivity, right? And so you see a lot of this actually happening much more on the central and eastern side of Mumbai. The second is, where are more and more jobs getting created? Ultimately, you want to stay closer to where you work, right? Because infrastructure will always still remain a challenge. Once again, you actually see a lot more movement in the Thane, Navi Mumbai, Kalyan, Dombivli, eastern suburban belt, where more and more jobs get created, BKC for that matter, right? And then the third factor is, what is the overall social amenities, retail, schools, so quality of life. When these three come together, I think those micro markets will do better. And then within the micro market, there's another variable, which is this notion of mixed use developments, where this concept of work, live, learn and play can come together. And this you typically see in larger developments, right? So a factor of these two is how I would look at a micro market and within a micro market, a project. So for me, the micro markets within the island city of Mumbai, if I had to look at it, I think Lower Parel, in spite of all the positives, negatives, it continues to attract a lot of interest. It still remains the aspirational one for people who are looking for homes in the 4 to 10 crore segment. Lower Parel, that will always do well. The second is, to me, is the Chembur area. The third is the Wadala belt, right? Wadala is a very interesting place because it's probably seeing the best connectivity story happening. Recently, MMRDA has launched, has released its master plan and its plan for making it the next BKC. So, everything that you would want from a future point is already coming together in Wadala.
And it's come a long way since, say, like a decade back, you know, where it was absolutely like, you know, the connectivity was the main issue with the location, and it seems to have turned around completely on that.
So, it's a dramatic change what's happening out there. We have a project there called New Cuff Parade, and you know, the way I see the project developing, progressing, sales, we've recently released 4 towers for possession, has been phenomenal because people are really understanding the connectivity story, right? So these would be the areas, I think, in the island city where I see disproportionate growth, right, relative to the overall island city. Then I would look at the suburbs. In the suburbs, to me, the Thane area continues to see phenomenal growth, right, just because it has a great connectivity story. It has lots of jobs. The social infrastructure is becoming very, very good. You've got the traditional Navi Mumbai belt. Navi Mumbai is very large, so it's kind of hard sometimes to pin down because you've got so many within that sub-micro markets and all are not the same because some are quite expensive now versus the other ones, but where the infrastructure, the social amenities still not fully developed. So you got to find the right pockets. I think the exciting one to me is the Kalyan Dombivli region. Not just because our largest project, or probably the largest in the country, Palava, is there. Right? But it's just in terms of how dramatically the entire region is changing. And if there is any area that is probably seeing the urbanization story, affordable housing, mid-income story coming together in Mumbai, is probably the Kalyan Dombivli belt. So these are probably the six micro markets that I feel where we will see disproportionate growth going forward.
And what have been the price trends that you have noticed in the locations, you know, that you have mentioned? Because I think that would be very important for our viewers as well, especially if I'm an investor and I'm just sort of trying to get a sense of, you know, where should I be looking at in Mumbai? So if you could just give us like a pricing overview as well.
Sure. So I think it's important to qualify when we say pricing, right? So today, what you'll find in the Mumbai micro market is when sales are happening, they are happening primarily with credible developers, developers who have the right professional teams, the ability to deliver a quality product. So automatically, you will see that their price will be higher than, let's say, a mom and pop developer. But actually, there's no sale in the mom and pop developer. So when I talk about pricing trends, I will speak more from a standpoint of what I consider as credible grade A developments, right? So let's start from probably the lowest end, right? Yeah. So I would think that would be the Kalyan Dombivli region.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I'll speak from my project. You can extrapolate other developers around the area. So at Palava, a one bedroom would start at roughly around 40 lakhs.
Okay.
And you can go up to a three bedroom apartment at approximately 70 lakhs, 70, okay. 75 lakhs, right? So that's the price point for buyers in that category.
Okay.
And that's probably the ones where almost all the incentive schemes of affordable housing, Pradhan Mantri Yojana, additional interest benefit, all of that will be applicable.
Yeah.
So it's not just the ticket price, but the EMIs will be much lower.
Yeah.
So you could be looking at after-tax EMIs of 20,000 to 25,000 per month.
Okay.
Right? So that's the Kalyan Dombivli region. Navi Mumbai is actually very variable.
Yeah.
You can get homes similar like Kalyan Dombivli, but then all the way similar to even more expensive than Thane.
True.
Right? So it's a very wide area. And so that's the range you can think about.
Okay.
If you take Thane, to me, there again, you know, I'll speak from the projects we have where we've got multiple like Amara, we've got Splendora, we've got Luxuria on Ghodbandar Road, Kolshet Road, etc.
Yeah.
So in that micro market, I think a one bedroom at about 60 to 70 lakhs, up to 1.2, 1.3 crores for a three bedroom is probably what you're looking at as the price range, right? That one can see.
Okay.
Then you come to, I'll go to Wadala first,
where
I think you can look at a one bedroom at a project like New Cuff Parade, which will be starting at about 1.5 crores.
Okay.
And you could go to a large three bedroom at 3.5 to 4 crores.
Okay.
So that's kind of the range you will look at in Wadala.
Okay.
And Wadala continues to see higher price as connectivity gets better.
Yeah.
It's going to just keep going up.
Yeah.
Chembur, on the other hand, would be probably, I'd say, about 5 to 10% lower than Wadala.
Yeah.
So that would be your price adjustment if you're looking at the Chembur belt.
Yeah.
And then Lower Parel is again another market, Lower Parel, where you have a full gamut of pricing. But a two bedroom, I would say, in Parel would be at 3 to 4 crores, in Lower Parel at 4.5 to 5.5 crores.
Yeah.
And then you keep going up, and then as the sizes vary, or the finishes vary, it can keep changing.
True.
So what I've gauged from what you have just shared with us is that if I'm an affordable home buyer or an investor for that matter, for me, the Thane, the Kalyan Dombivli belt and Navi Mumbai, that becomes pivotal for me. Of course, if I have excess corpus, I could be looking at these kind of locations, and which, like you said, you know, the connectivity and the social infrastructure, everything is completely at play over here. So I'm going to end this with the one question I'm sure even you get asked a lot, I also get asked a lot, and which is from the fence sitters. Is this a good time to buy? Should they wait on some more, or is the waiting time over? Should they now at least take the plunge and look for a home to buy? What do you think?
You know, again, I think it's always helpful to look at our own data because then that's factual, right?
Yeah.
I'll put it with a caveat because we probably had the strongest year we've had in a long time.
Okay.
I don't think the market as a whole may have had the same thing.
Okay.
It goes back to that credible developer gaining more share.
Yeah.
But what I'm seeing within my own portfolio, right? Volume and pricing in the affordable and mid segment, right? I would say up to the 1.5, 2 crores from 40 lakhs all the way to 2 crores, that momentum has been very strong in the last 9 months.
Yeah.
And I'm already seeing pricing go up.
Okay.
So if you've not already bought in this segment and you're looking to buy a home, you should not wait.
Yeah.
Interest rates have bottomed out. It's not going to go any lower.
Yeah.
So you're going to get at the best interest rates, getting all the schemes, all the benefits and pricing, which may be at best a few percentage points higher than 6 months ago.
Yeah.
Get in now.
Okay.
Don't wait. Whether you're an investor or whether you're an end user, right? And you have a good choice of ready homes as well as under construction.
True.
I think everything in real estate will ultimately then you go down from one end of the spectrum and then moves up.
True.
So this is what we've always seen.
Yeah.
So in about 6 to 12 months, the segment which I think is around the, let's say, 2 crores to, you know, 5 crores.
Okay.
And I won't talk too much about luxury.
Yeah.
I see that picking up quite well. Right, again, because inventory is coming down, supply not too many launches.
True.
So as the existing inventory gets taken out, not too much new supply, I will start seeing good price growth in that segment as well in 6 to 12 months.
Okay.
So in that segment, if you haven't bought, start looking actively.
Okay.
And start making the decision now.
Yeah.
Because you don't want to wait till prices start going up.
Yeah.
Right? So both segments, good time to buy.
Yeah.
The first segment already started.
Yeah.
Can't wait at all.
Okay.
Second one, you have at best 6 months.
So what you're saying is, for especially for the fence sitters, that the trend of prices bottoming out or rationalization, that definitely has stopped, and you know it doesn't look like it's going to go down any further. Would is that the assessment that you have made?
I think prices are not going down for sure.
Okay.
It actually hasn't gone down much.
Okay.
What you've seen is apartments have become smaller.
Yeah.
But the per square foot price
yeah.
has not come down, and it's not going to come down.
Oh.
Right. So if that's your hope. I think you may be disappointed. Mumbai in general has been a much safer market
yeah.
compared to all the other metros.
Yeah.
And so I think that's why this is a good time to go out there and make a decision.
Well, that's great advice. We've given you guys something to think about. That's all that we have time for today. Thank you so much for tuning in. Please do keep track of us on Facebook, LinkedIn and Twitter. And we'll be seeing you guys soon. Bye-bye.